सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांति।
जॉइन द हैंड्स एट बैक ऑफ द बॉडी एंड बो फॉरवर्ड टू द मदर सुप्रीम अर्थ। Inhale, come back, rub the palms against each other. And place the hands over the eyes and face. Slide the hands over the face, slowly open the eyes. Good morning, everybody. Jai Shri Krishna. Let's start practice with our usual way, with warm up. Try to keep hands, the arms parallel to the floor. Alternate. So 90 degree up, 90 degree down. So we'll try to utilize all the joints. So we have 360 joints in the body. Spread the fingers apart and bend all the fingers at each of the knuckle joints. Try to keep elbows straight. Make tight fist, thumbs inside, and release a few times. Then keep the fist together, roll them forward. And again, continue, just try to keep the elbow straight. Few times inward direction. Okay, swing the hands, inhale when elbows go up, exhale when they go down. So connect the fingers together on shoulders. I think we have a couple of new people today joined first time. So if possible, please try to keep the camera unmute. Just the camera, not the mic. Few times sideways. And hold all the fingers together at shoulder. Make a big circle. Inhale when the elbows go up. Exhale when go down. Biggest circle possible. And when you no need to look at the screen, you can close the eyes and you can keep full awareness on each of these movements. Make a 90 degree. Inhale, exhale. You can align the palms, but don't drop the elbows. Elbows should remain at the shoulder level. And also, elbows make sure it's about 90 degree. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. If possible, few times, try to just make bend like this. And in this case, the upper arm should remain parallel to the floor. And release. Then bring the right hand at back of the body. Left palm behind the right knee, exhale, turn towards right, look all the way back as we push the knee forward. Inhale, come back to center and same thing on other side. And feel the twist at the lower back. One more time, both sides. Okay. Interlock the fingers, place palms over the forehead. Inhale, hold the breath while we pressing head and the palms against each other. And release the breath, and same thing from the back. Push the elbows towards back. One more time, front and back. And two times sideways. Keep both palms on the knees. Exhale, turn towards right. Align chin with the right shoulder. Hold there 3 to 5 seconds. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, go towards left. One more time, right and left. Next, bring chin at the chest. Inhale, make a circle. Start looking towards right, then up. From up, start exhalation. Turn the head towards left. Bring it down. One more circle from right to left. Try to make biggest circle. And two times other direction. Okay, sit in L shape, Dandasana, pole pose, both palms on the side. So the legs and trunk will make perfect L shape. Squeeze and release toes a few times. Push toes forward. Pull them back. Try to keep knees straight. Inhale when you push them forward. Exhale when you pull them back towards the body. Few times together. And then alternate, one push, one pull. Then circle the toes around the heels, utilizing the ankle joints. And two times reverse direction. Fold the one leg, put on midpoint of the other leg, interlock the fingers with the toes, use the other palm few times to push it down to the floor. And then exhale, just use the palm and bring knee to the chin. Inhale, push it down to the floor, hold there a couple of seconds. Then bring the knee to chin. Two more times on the same side. then switch to the other side. So this will increase the blood circulation into the hip joint, pelvis area. First few times, just push them towards the floor. It's like spring. We push it and it comes up itself. And then at least 4 to 5 times, bring the knee to the chin. Inhale when push it down. Exhale when bring it to the chin. Fold both the legs, align the feet, interlock the fingers, place them over the toes, sit straight, first few times, move it all the way up to all the way down, and then speed up a little bit, but try to bring the knees closer to the floor. Okay, control the side by side, bring the body closer to the heels, sit straight, hold the toes tight, elbows straight, keep pushing knees to the floor, close the eyes, look straight, shoulder relaxed, but try to keep elbows straight. Deeply inhale, hold the breath. At least 3 to 5 seconds. When you hold the breath, make sure we keep pressing the knees down to the floor. With closed eyes, keep awareness into the pelvis area, hip joint area, and see how you feel the extra stretch. So deeply inhale, deeply exhale. So this is Bhadrasana, or also called Bhadrasana. Now push the body backward. Don't go too far away. Inhale, look up. Hold the toes tight. Exhale, try not to buckle the back. Just bend it from the lower back. Try to push trunk forward. When you can no longer bring the trunk forward, that point you can drop the head. Inhale, come back up one more time. And we can use our elbows to push the lower leg back to bring the trunk forward. Inhale, exhale, and go down. That was Baddha Konasana. Now let's cross leg, but don't make paranti. Try to align the lower leg on top of each other. So one leg over the other leg, but try to align the lower leg. Bring both hands, the palms forward. Keep walking the hands inch by inch forward. And let's bring the trunk and head go down. All the way down, as much as you can. Okay, walk the hands back and switch the legs. So whichever leg is up, that leg's hip joint, you will feel some extra stretch. Okay, walk the hands back. Now you can sit in regular cross leg posture or Siddhasan, Sukhasan or Padmasan. We'll do Parvatasan. Bring both hands on a side. As we inhale, bring both palms together in front of chest, Prana Mudra. Exhale, inhale again. Bring both palms over the head. Keep full awareness on each of the movement. Exhale here. Inhale. Raise both palms all the way up. The elbows straight. The whole trunk stretch up. Both the arms also completely stretch up. As we exhale, start lowering the palms down. Back to the top of head. Pranam mudra. And all the way down. By that time, we should be completely exhale out. So do two more times with breath coordination. Do with your own pace, but do with the closed eyes and keep full awareness on movement and breathing. Next, let's do some of the breathing exercise. We'll do pranayama, bhastrika pranayama, deeply inhale, deeply exhale, bring both palms sideways. So as we raise both the hands up, inhalation coordinate with breathing. So we will be fully inhale as we bring both the palms together at top of the head. Sit straight, trunk straight. As we exhale, start lowering the hands, both sides. By the time we bring our hands all the way closer to the floor, we should be fully exhaled. So continue with this pattern. Inhale slowly but deeply inhale while bring both palms up. Exhale when you bring them down. Each time we inhale and we are bringing our hands up, imagine, visualize a ball of energy forming around us. Just imagine that. And as we exhale, as we bring hands down, just pretend that that energy is sinking into our body, into both the hands, head, and throughout the whole body, all the way to the toes. So do this with visualization. Should be deeply inhale, deeply exhale. And last round, if you are bringing your hands down, just relax. Bring the right hand up, roll first two fingers into root of thumb, Vishnu Mudra. We will do Surya Nadi Pranayama. Breathe in from right and breathe out from right. Right and right only. Use the ring fingertip to continuously block the left nostril. Bring the hand up sideways at the shoulder level. Other hands can be in Dhyan Mudra or any other mudra. But deeply inhale, deeply exhale. Okay, relax the hand, breathe normal. Next we'll do Kapalbhati Pranayama. Hands in Vayu Mudra, roll first finger tip into the root of thumb. Deeply inhale once and exhale out into multiple exhalation. And we can, unknowingly we can breathe in between, that's okay. But with actively we're gonna forcefully breathe out. Each the small portion each time. Conclude when you breathe out completely. That was Kapalbhati Pranayama, one of the Shat Kriya cleansing technique that throws out toxins from the bottom of our lungs. Next we'll do variation of Bhastrika Pranayama, make a fist. So we will do first time inhale, exhale, second time inhale front, exhale, and third time sideway, inhale, exhale. So make fist each time we bring the palms closer to the body. All three directions. and release. Release the hands, breathe normal. So that all creates some heat in the body. That's what the whole purpose. We were warming up. So we did enough. Let's do with some poses. Spread the legs. Make sure the knees are straight. Inhale, look up. Expand the chest, both hands up. Exhale, push the trunk forward, bend from the lower back. Try to grab the big toes or feet as far as you can go. You can hold the steady, sustained pressure at the lower back. And try not to lift the knees. Inhale, come back up one more time. And each time exhale, try to keep head further down. Okay, inhale, come back up. Let's do Kurma Asan. Kurma, I think it's Kachbo. Bring both hands under the knees, under the legs, and try to bring head closer to the floor. No need to bring the forehead touching the floor, but as far as you can go. Just hold the pressure as far as you can go down. Also again, you can inhale, exhale here. Each time exhale, you can keep pressing the head down. Okay, release. Inhale, turn towards left. Raise both hands up, look up. Exhale, bend forward with both hands equally. Grab the left foot and try to bring forehead closer to the left knee. Try to keep the knees straight. Inhale, come back up and turn towards right. Look up. Exhale fully, grab the right foot and try to bring head closer to the right knee. Inhale, come back up one more time, longer duration. Deeply inhale, look up, expand the chest, and you should be turned towards the left leg first, then exhale, bend forward. Inhale, exhale in a pose. Each time exhale, try to get the head closer to the knee. Okay, inhale, come back up. And the right side, a little bit longer duration. Okay, release both the hands, interlock the fingers and turn the palms the other way. Let's do Chakki Chalanasana. Try to keep the elbows straight, hold the palms around all the way over the toes and knees. Inhale when we bend backward, exhale when we bend forward.
can do with the closed eyes.
4 to 5 circles in one direction
and then switch the direction.
Don't do too fast.
Do with the gentle movement.
With closed eyes, you can keep full awareness on each of the movements and the stretch you feel in the pelvis and hip joints. Okay, and release. Both legs a little bit closer, so keep couple of feet away. The feet should be a couple of feet away. And just drop the head at the back for a couple of breathing. And then bring both the palms on one side, and on the same side you can drop the knees on the floor as well, the toes on the floor as well, and turn towards that side, look at the back, and while holding the twist, bend the forehead to the floor, fold the elbows, and the other side. First few seconds, hold the twist, and then you can bring the forehead to the floor. Bring both the legs together, align all the way down, both palms at the back. We will do Purva Uttanasana. So you can go halfway, just rest the elbows on the floor, drop the head at the back, or you can do it fully, bring both palms on the floor, inhale, raise the body up, push the toes down to the floor, raise the knees up, trunk all the way up, drop the head at the back, so there will be a straight line from back up to head, to the heels. This is Purva Uttanasana or reverse plank. Very slowly bring the body back to the floor and get into L-shape Dandasana, pole pose. Now we will do complementary pose. Paschimottanasana, so Paschimottanasana and Purva Uttanasana, complementary to each other. So look up, raise both hands up, deeply inhale, exhale fully, bring both hands on the feet, tuck the stomach in, see if you can push the head closer to the knee. Do one more time, Paschimottanasana. And if you cannot reach all the way, if you cannot grab the feet like this, fold the legs a little bit, the way you can, then you can grab the feet. Then, while holding the feet, straighten the legs. And then you can further exhale out fully and try to drop the head. Okay. Next, we will keep the left leg straight, grab the big toe with left hand, grab the big left toe,
right hand, grab the right ankle and try to pull the right foot at the right ear. You can block the right ear with the right foot. Akarna Dhanurasana.
धनुष नु बाण चढ़ावे ने रीते एंड स्विच द लेग माइट नॉट बी एबल टू डू इट फुल्ली बट एज मच एज यू कैन डू एंड देन विथ कंटिन्यूअस प्रैक्टिसिंग यू विल गेट देयर. So that way, all of those body parts and joints, we can twist them, tweak them into all different kind of angles. Let's get into the Gomukhasana. Fold both the legs. So whichever leg, whichever knee is up, that side hand will go up, and if you have difficulty reaching out to connecting both the hands together, you can use napkin or anything, the yoga strap, belt or anything. You can use that and you can slowly, I'm just showing it here, and then at the back you can slowly bring the hands closer to each other and gradually you should be able to progress enough to hold, to connect both the hands. Once you connect them with any of these things or without, then look straight, the level of eyes, trunk straight. Even you can close the eyes and imagine your posture into the mind, just like we're looking in mirror. Okay, release the hands and switch to the other side. Gomukhasana, cow face pose. So also you can try to do this. When you pull the hand from the top, you can use other hand, just push it down a little bit at beginning. Hold it there and then you can bring the other hand up. So that way you will probably be able to connect both the palms. Then look up straight. Straighten the trunk. And release the hands. Next we'll do Ardha Matsyendrasana. Keep whichever knee is down, that leg keep edges. The other leg, bring the foot slightly outward of the other knee. Not in front, slightly outward. And whichever knee is up, that side hand will go at back of the body, the palm aligned with the spine. Inhale, raise the other hand up. And bring it, exhale, just bring it around the knee and try to grab the knee which is on the floor. Exhale fully and turn back the head. The chin should align with the shoulder which is at the back. I'm not saying right or left, it depends on whatever you started with. Ardha Matsyendrasana. And you will feel so much extra twist into the lower back. And gently switch to the other side. This pose is a combination of Vakrasana and Gomukhasana. They blend into one. Okay.
So let's come back, sit in Vajrasana or any of the posture you will be comfortable with, cross leg or Vajrasana. So મારા રસલા કાકે અનમ્યુટ કરો, એ કંઈક આપણે તે દિવસે થોડુંક કમ્યુનિકેશન બાકી રહી ગયું હતું, કન્વર્ઝેશન. આપણે ત્રણ ત્રણ વસ્તુના સેટ કરતા હતા ને, એમાંથી એક લક્ષ્મીજી ઉપર આવ્યું હતું, વોઝ વેરી ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ, પણ વી હેડ ટુ સ્ટોપ ધેર ધેટ ટાઈમ, વોઝ વી આર રનિંગ આઉટ ઓફ ટાઈમ. તો ક્યાં ગયા રસલા કાકી? હા,
લક્ષ્મી, અલક્ષ્મી અને મહાલક્ષ્મી. લક્ષ્મી એટલે પરાર્થે વપરાય તે લક્ષ્મી, પરાર્થ એટલે બીજા માટે સારા કામ માટે વપરાય તે લક્ષ્મી. અલક્ષ્મી એટલે પરપીડા માટે, એટલે કોઈને પીડા આપવા માટે જે લક્ષ્મી વપરાય એને અલક્ષ્મી કે, ને પ્રભુ કાર્ય માટે જે વપરાય લક્ષ્મી એને મહાલક્ષ્મી કે.
વેરી ગુડ, યસ, પરફેક્ટ, થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ, ગુડ. ના, ધેર ઇઝ પરફેક્ટ એક્સપ્લેનેશન. તો
શક્તિ હોતે છે, ત્રણ શક્તિ છે, શક્તિ, અશક્તિ અને મહાશક્તિ. જે શક્તિ છે તે કર્ણ છે, કર્ણ એ શક્તિ વાપરી પણ પરાર્થે વાપરી કે દુર્યોધન નો સાથ આપીને, ને અશક્તિ છે એ દુર્યોધન છે એટલે પરપીડા માટે વપરાણી, ને જે મહાશક્તિ છે એ અર્જુન છે કે એને ભગવાન માટે શક્તિ બધી વાપરી.
બરાબર, ભગવાન ના કેવા પ્રમાણે, રાઈટ રાઈટ. તો મને લાગે અશક્તિ ને બદલે કુશક્તિ કહી શકાય ને, કદાચ શબ્દ તો
વિચાર આવે, કુશક્તિ નો આવે, કુ વિચાર આવે,
તો ઓલો શબ્દ જેની આરે પ્રાસ મળતો એ રીતે. હા 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 હા, ગ્રેટ, થેન્ક યુ. તો તમે આ બે વસ્તુ એડ કરી એમાં, એક્સલન્ટ. તો આપણે બીજી વાત કરતા હતા કે યા, સો ક્લાસીસ મારે ગઈકાલે ચાલુ થઈ ગયા એકચ્યુઅલી. ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ આઈ લુક એટ ઓલ ધ આસના ધેટ કવર્ડ, ગુડ થિંગ ઇઝ કે 90% પ્રોબ્લી મોર ધેન 90% આસના પોઝિસ ધેટ વી ઓલરેડી ન્યૂ, સો ધીસ ઇઝ ગુડ થિંગ. સો વી વર ડુઈંગ વોટ એવર વી શુડ ડુ, એન્ડ સમ ઓફ ધો 10%, and I believe, I haven't looked at it yet, but out of those 10%, at least half of them, definitely they probably use just the different names, but we've been doing under different names. So we still will know what the poses are. So we'll see, but it's a big, so many things that I have to follow, so I'm going to be busy for several weeks. But we will try not to disturb our sessions. Our session times will remain same, unless sometimes we have few other teachers in audience, sometimes we may have someone else lead our session. Yeah, and I'm already talking with Chaturbhai. We'll have Satish Bhai from Atlanta. He's very good at anatomy and all of these things. We will have one day, which day we haven't decided yet, so he will lead the session, one session, and will give us very good information on anatomy, body anatomy, or probably going to go through asanas, the whole session as well, just yoga poses, everything. Okay, so let's continue with our some poses. Sit in Vajrasana. If you are not already, try to keep the knees at least about 1 foot away, both hands forward, make tight fist, thumb inside, make tight fist, deeply inhale and hold the breath in lower abdomen, then tightly place the fist on the navel, forcefully exhale, don't leave the heels, and lower the trunk all the way down. When you can no longer lower the trunk, that point you can tilt the head slightly up. And continuously feeling the pressure at the navel.
Inhale, come back up. Let's do one more time. Next we'll do Supta Vajrasana, backward bending. Stay in a Vajrasana first to start with. Bring both palms at the back. You can go halfway. If you are not comfortable doing this pose fully, you can stay in this pose but drop the head at the back and you can lower, relax the lower back. Or you can just slide the hands forward. Lay down, back on the ground, back of the head, fully rested, both knees on the floor. Even you can bring both palms on the thigh, top of the thighs. And you can relax the whole body. Don't hold any muscles, any body parts. With closed eyes, you can quickly scan the whole body. Supta Vajrasana, or another name is Supine Vajrasana. Grab the ankles, push the elbows down to the floor, and bring the body up back to Diamond Pose, Vajrasana. Next we'll do child pose. Bring both knees couple of feet apart in order to accommodate the whole trunk. We will do slightly differently. Raise both hands up, look up, the whole trunk stretch upward. Now as we exhale slowly, try to bring the trunk and head, everything down to the floor, but don't leave the heels. The back will be continuously touching the heels. Chest, chin on the floor, both hands extended over the head. Relax the lower back, relax the shoulders, and deeply inhale, deeply exhale a couple of times. And you can walk the hands closer to the body and let the trunk and head automatically rise. Okay. And again, stand on the knees, both the knees. Keep the knees and feet same width as the shoulder. Inhale in circular fashion, raise the one hand up, exhale, rest it on the same side heel. Inhale on the other hand, rest onto the other side on the heels, drop the head at the back, keep pushing the trunk forward, and hold in a pose, maintain both the forces. Continuously pushing the trunk forward, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay. Come out of the pose one hand at a time. Don't jerk the body very slowly. Come out of the pose and bring both palms on the floor. Look straight up, We'll do cat and cow pose, Marjoryasana.
Inhale, look up. Spine will be downward arch.
Exhale, try to make the spine upward arch.
Do few more times. Inhale fully. And also you can push the lower back up as well in order to make the good arch.
And vice versa. When you look down, try to lower the lower back further. Couple more times.
Now both elbows straight, look straight, extend the right leg back, the right knee straight, the right toes on the floor. Just push the body forward and pull it back. Hold the toes at the same point on the ground. And when you push the body back, feel the extra strength into the right calf muscles. Then bring the right leg all the way towards right and bend sideways and look at the right leg, then bring the right leg all the way towards left, as far as you can bring, bend towards the left side and look at the right leg. Do two more times, towards right and left. So each time you're gonna keep the toes on the ground. Okay, then bring the right knee next to the left knee and extend the left leg back, left toes on the floor, both palms on the floor, push the body forward, holding the toes at the same point on the floor. Try to keep body straight few times, push the body forward few times. Back. Then bring the left foot all the way towards the left, bend towards the left and look at the left leg, and bring the left leg towards the right side. All the way right, and try to look at the whole left leg. Two more times on left and right. And get on both the knees. We'll do gate pose, Parikasana. Extend the right leg, right knee straight. Inhale, raise the left hand up, bend the sideways towards right. Slide the right hand along with the right leg. You can reach all the way to the ankles. Keep looking up or just look at the left hand. Okay. Bring the left palm side of the right knee. Inhale, exhale, 3, 4, toes stretch out. And hold the leg straight. Can drop the head a little bit, the whole trunk, leg, and head will make one straight horizontal line. Okay, bring the leg down and raise the hand, the right hand up. Inhale first and then exhale and push it down. Also push the left palm into the floor. Try to make the left, the whole arm straight. So the midpoint of the arch will go a little bit up. And also you keep holding the pressure on leg and the hand down. So it will be great arch. Keep looking up to the ceiling. And slowly release the hand. Both knees on the floor. And same thing on the other side. Parikshana, gate pose, and it's a couple of variations. Inhale, exhale, and bend sideways. Okay. One, two, three, four, five. Toes stretch out and hold the leg up in the air. Okay, bring the leg down, inhale, raise the left hand up, exhale, keep pushing the left hand towards the floor, keep looking up or look towards the left hand, push the right palm to the floor, full stretch on the whole left side. Okay, slowly come out of the pose. And let's stand. Stand on feet. But feet closer. Inhale, raise both hands up and go on the toes. You can interlock the fingers, press the palms towards the floor. Exhale, bring the heels to the floor. Inhale, heels up, all the way up. Exhale, down. Do three more times. And at the last round, we will bring heels up and hold it at the last round. Okay, so hold the pose, keep pushing the palms towards the ceiling. Okay, bring the hands down. We'll do variation, just relax the feet a little bit. Inhale, go on the toes, the hands halfway. Exhale, pretend we are sitting on the low chair, imaginary chair. We're not gonna sit down fully. And come back. We will do another variation. Inhale, go on the toes, raise the hands halfway. Exhale,
sit in the imaginary chair. Inhale, raise both hands up. You can look at the level of the eyes. And come back up. Let's walk around the mat. Walk on the toes. Make two circles. And then after two circles, then walk on the heels. Two circles. Spread the legs as wide as possible. Taller foxes can go at closer to edges of the mat. Bring both hands forward, parallel. Inhale, exhale, start turning toward one side, and you need to fold one hand. You can grab the other shoulder and you continuously following the straight hand. Keep on going. You can go even, you can pass the back, you can look on the other side as well. Come back, inhale, and go towards the other side. Feel the twist at the waist. Now do it a little bit faster, but do deeply inhale, deeply exhale, and at least another 5 rounds. And each time, make both hands parallel to each other when it comes to the center. So all of this activity, as you notice, that it's gonna reduce some fat into our tummy area, waist area. Definitely it has to. So while talking about that, I'm gonna tell you one thing. It's exactly, not exactly, a few more months, more than 25 years, I landed in US first time. Whatever weight I had in back in 1995, I had exact same weight today. At least since last week or last 2 weeks. So I put my graph all the way back to where I was in 1995. So this all helps basically. From March to today, the weight graph is just straight down line. So all of these activities we do, it not just helps on those fat and those things, but each of the joints is gonna day by day keep collecting the toxins, and it has to thrown out. That's the whole reason we get joint issue and everything, right? So with all these activities, yogas and those things, toxins keep getting released. And with fluid we drink whenever we do yoga or any exercise, so later, not during session, but you try to intake some more liquid, so the toxins, whatever release, get flushed out. So multiple benefits. And in this literature, what I got, I haven't got everything, it was an online course, but at least I looked at, has vat, pit, cough things, has diet related things. It also covers yoga poses and Ayurveda side things, and many times we covered some of those topics in our session last year. It has everything in it. So I'm so glad seeing that material, that we were very close to what we should be. All right, let's do Tiryak Tadasan. Bring both legs a little bit closer. Connect the interlock the fingers, Tiryak Tadasan, swaying palm tree pose. Inhale, exhale, bend sideways, keeping the elbows and knees straight. Keep looking toward the ceiling. Okay, come back up. Inhale, exhale, bend towards the other side. Okay, one more time. When you do that, feel the full stretch on the opposite side. Turn the left foot 90 degree outward. Right foot will still point the front. Bend at the left knee. Bring the right hand next to the left foot. You can put few inches away. The left palm will be on the floor. And raise the left hand up towards the ceiling and try to push the lower back closer to the floor as down as possible, and keep looking the left hand fingers, look at the ceiling. Okay, and other side. The trailing leg will remain straight. Okay. And we will do our standard Parshva Konasan. Again, same feet position. Bend at the left knee and bring the left hand close to the left palm. Or you can hold it here. If you cannot go all the way down, you can hold at the left ankle or left foot, or you can bring all the way down to the floor. Raise the other hand up and bring it down. So the trailing leg, trunk and the hand make straight line, and specifically this waist area we should try to bring, should not try to make the angle, but we should push it down. Try that and keep looking toward the ceiling. Okay, and the other side. Okay, let's move in front of the mat. Let's do 5 Surya Namaskar today with the mantras. So while you stand at the front of the mat, just stand in a Tadasana, let the body relax from the previous poses, close the eyes and feel the vibration throughout the body. Breathe in and out normal. Let the body relax. So you should be able to do Surya Namaskar nicely. Okay, let's start. And try to chant mantras along.
भानवे नमः।
Thank you.
Great. So we got a 60 asanas, right? 12 times 5. We did 5 Surya Namaskars. So that covers so many all other different body parts, twisting. So let's sit in a Malasan. Squatting pose. Heels and toes flat on the floor. Maybe you can just keep the feet separated, toes even a little bit further outward. So that way you may be able to sit with the flat feet. You can sit in any other posture. Bring the right palm on the floor from inside the knee. And even try to push the knees outward. And the other hand, extend diagonally upward towards the ceiling and look through those fingers up in the air and feel the twist on diagonally on other side of the lower back. Okay, and other side. Okay, let's do one more time, both sides. And even you can push the palms even further forward. Okay. So let's join both palms at the back. Paschim Namaskar. Push the palms all the way up, turn around so I can see the progress. Yeah, some of them you can push a little bit up, or maybe just day by day you should be able to get there. Spread the legs apart. Try to keep the knees straight. Inhale, exhale, turn towards one side. Exhale, bend forward. And try to bring the head closer to the knee. As close as possible. And feel extra stretch into the hamstring and calf muscles and the knee joint. Inhale, come back up, bend backward. Stay in the same direction, don't move the head forward yet. Okay, then exhale and back to center. Inhale, turn towards the other side. Exhale, bend forward. Try to bring forehead closer to the knee. Inhale, bend backward. Exhale, come back to front. Inhale, exhale, bend forward. Let the trunk, the upper body, hang loosely at the hip joints. Don't hold the upper body, let it go further down and down. Okay, inhale, come back up and bend backward. Okay, release the hands, relax them. Try to do few balancing poses. Keep the one foot sturdy, make sure it's straight, a palm. You can spread the toes apart, make sure it is fully rested. Then very slowly lift the other foot up. Grab the ankle joint and align the foot with the inner thigh of the other leg. Lock the foot and raise both the hands up. So the knee would go sideways. Also we can do in a pranam as well. That would be just a variation. But the best challenge would be at the top, but we can do either way, or you can do both. And release, and the other side. But do it very slowly. If you do any of the balancing poses, come into the pose too quick, you will be come out quickly as well. Do with the quiet mind. Okay, let's do Garudasana. Is there any new person, new yogi started doing Garudasana? Then go ahead and say your name, because we don't want to waste so long time on waiting.
So you can intertwine the legs, lock. Then you can work on hand at the end. Then bend backward. We should not be lean forward. Our trunk would go down. And the other side. You don't have to, your foot doesn't have to go all the way down. It can be just halfway, or you can just add the calf muscles. But gradually you will get there. So don't think that you're not able to do it. But you can still do it. With daily practice, we should be able to stay in that pose longer and longer duration. Yeah, I see many people doing it. Wow. So what's a Ramanik Kaka? Yeah, so many people are able to do that now. Okay, another balancing is, we can stand on the one foot, and we can make a circle with the other leg. See how many able to do that. And opposite side, also try to bend at the knee as well, and trying to keep balance. And the other leg. Okay. Again, you can switch the leg. You can swing the leg forward and backward without touching that foot on the floor at all. All the way up, all the way down. Okay, good. That was enough for today. So let's get back to the floor. Before I forget, I think 2-5 divas pehla ek flyer post kiryu tu ke Raju bhai Balani nu pehli vakhat apne eno potano musical program આજે એટેન્ડ કરવા જઈ રહ્યા છીએ 11 o'clock. હિમસેલ્ફ વિલ બી સિંગિંગ એઝ વેલ ટુડે એન્ડ હિઝ ગ્રુપ ઇઝ એન ઓર્કેસ્ટ્રા એન્ડ અધર લાઈક દેર આર 3-4 ટોટલ સિંગર્સ બટ હિમસેલ્ફ હી વિલ બી સિંગિંગ એઝ વેલ સો હી હેઝ વેરી ગુડ વોઇસ હી સિંગ્સ ઇન મુકેશ વોઇસ હી ડુ કિશોર કુમાર એન્ડ મુકેશ બોથ બટ હી સેઝ દેટ પીપલ પ્રિફર હિમ સિંગિંગ મોર ઓન મુકેશ સો હી પ્રોબ્લી યુ ગોના હિયર મુકેશ સોંગ્સ from him today. 11 o'clock, and if you delete the poster, I might post it again. But it was in a group, I think I did. Okay, so let's lay down on a stomach. Both hands over the head, straight. Toes stretch back, feel the full stretch. Inhale, exhale, normal. With next inhalation, raise the hands, head, chin up, and pull both the legs up. Continue stretching the toes out, the thighs over the floor. I mean above the floor. Okay. Rest in Makarasana. Fold both hands, both legs separated, and put the face on a sideways.
Okay. Bring the chin, chest on the floor, shoulder blade on the floor, both hands at the back, cross the legs at the back and fold it, fold and cross, so both hands at the back, so grab ankle joints, right to left, left to right, inhale, raise head, chest, chin up, and pull the legs up. Variation of the bow pose, Dhanurasana, with the crossed leg. Keep pulling the leg up even further and pulling the head up as well. With inhale, exhale, you will feel a little bit rocking movement. That's good, it will internal massage organs. Okay, release the legs. Again, back to Makarasana for a few seconds. While in Makarasana, let the whole body part relax fully. You can close the eyes. Toes pointing out. Inhale, exhale, normal. Okay, both palms on the floor, elbows on the floor, look up, chest, chin up, both legs together, toes stretch out, hold both the legs, try to bring heels as close as to the body, and cross the legs, turn towards one side, and look at the feet. Come back straight, cross the legs other way, turn on a side way towards the other side, and look at the feet. Do one more time. And feel the spine and the back twisted at the middle back. Look at the other side. Good. Release, drop the legs, and again lay down in Makarasana. Few seconds. Okay, then there is another very good for the lower back, for the back issue. Let's watch the TV like the kids used to do. Bring the palms under the chin. And you can do this one leg at a time. Try to kick the own back. Or both the legs together. At the third time, you just let the lower back completely relaxed. You don't want to hold any muscles. Okay. And get back on the floor and turn around. Lay down in a Shavasana. Take rest in a Shavasana. And feel the relaxation, feel the vibration in the whole body, legs separated, toes pointing outward, both hands away from the body, fingers semi-closed, palms facing ceiling, neck, head and trunk in exact straight line. You can close the eyes, don't hold any muscle, any body parts. Will be fully relaxed. So this is Shavasana pose. So anytime when we say Shavasana, so this is the pose. During Yoga Nidra also we will be in this pose throughout the Yoga Nidra. Okay, both legs together, both hands on the side. Raise both hands up. Bring it over the head at the back. Toes stretch out. Pretend that we are a rope and there are two different energy pulling us into the opposite direction, pulling us away. Feel the pull stretch from toes to the fingers. Stretch, stretch, more stretch, and release. Bring both hands side of the body. Hold both the legs. Bring both knees closer to the chest. We can just hug the legs, and even we can grab the elbows on the both side. Raise the head up. Exhale. Try to bring chin and the knees as close as possible. Pavan Muktasan with both the legs same time. And release. Now interlock the fingers and grab at the ankle joints, both the legs. Keep the legs folded, knees still up. Hold it tightly and roll side by side. Massage the back and spine. You can relax the lower back as well so that it will touch the ground, and during this rolling and rocking it will touch, it will get massaged properly, and few times a rock. Stay within the mat area and let the whole spine get massaged on lengthwise. Okay, straighten both the legs. Lay down in a shavasana at least 10 seconds. Breathe in and out normal, close the eyes, relax fully. Keeping the left leg straight, fold the right knee and bring the right foot outward of the left knee and raise the left hand up, put it on the palm on the right knee, bring the right knee on the floor, right hand will be perpendicular to the body on the right side, and look towards the right palm, turn the head away towards the right palm while keep holding the right knee on the floor towards the left, and feel the full twist at the lower back. Okay, and switch to the other side. Straighten the right leg, hold the left leg with the right palm, push the left knee to the floor on right side, left hand extended perpendicular to the body towards left, and look to the left. Keeping the right leg straight, so leg, the right leg and trunk and head in one line. We are just twisting. And bring both legs together straight in a shavasana, 2 seconds. With next inhalation, raise the trunk and the legs 60 degrees over the ground, or you can go even more than that. try to keep elbows and knees straight and toes and fingers as close as possible. Sampurna Naukasana. So it would be roughly 60 degrees over the ground. Make sure trunk is raised equally as well. And double check the knees are straight. Okay, very slowly bring the legs back to the floor, hands to the floor, trunk, head, back to the Shavasana, at least 10 seconds. And during those Shavasana time, don't do any other activity, because the rest in between poses and some this kind of poses really absolutely needed. Bring both palms on the side of the body. So some people will do Uttan Padasana and stay in Uttan Padasana. Raise both legs up, 90 degree up, knees straight, and hold the pose at least half minute. And others can continue with the Sarvangasana. You can get ready like this for Sarvangasana and Halasana few times. Others will remain on the Uttan Padasana because they are not able to do any of this kind of poses. This is called inversions. And bring the toes toward the ground, Halasana. When we bring both legs up and hold at the waist, this is Sarvangasana, or also it called shoulder stand, because we are standing on the shoulder. In next few seconds, whoever doing Uttan Padasana, start lowering the legs down to the floor and rest in Shavasana. Other people who are doing Halasana or Sarvangasana, just very slowly keep laying down the upper back, middle back and lower back to the floor, and bring the legs back to the floor and lay down in Shavasana. At least 10 seconds. Next we'll do the pedaling. Bring both the hands to the side of the body, palms facing down to support the body. Hold both the legs and start pedaling forward. Make sure you keep stretching toes out when foot goes away from the body. 10 times forwarding, 10 times backward direction. And try to make the biggest circle. Pretend that we have a military bike, has big pedals. And after 10 pedal forward, do the 10 back pedal and come back to where you were. And then lay down in Shavasana. Back to sitting posture. We will do
cooling down pranayam. Start with Chandra Nadi. You can sit in any comfortable posture. Sit in Vajrasana as well. Hands in Vishnu Mudra. Make the right hand, first two fingers into root of thumb. With thumb tip continuously holding, blocking the right nostril. Deeply breathe in from left and breathe out from left. Left and left only. Chandra Nadi Pranayama. And other hand can be in Vayu Mudra. Roll first finger into root of thumb. Deeply breathe in from left and deeply breathe out from left. Okay. When you breathe out from left, just breathe in and out normal. We will do Bhramari Pranayama. Hands in Sanmukhi Mudra. We will block the ear canal with thumb tip. We will do it three times. Use the ring finger tip to block the nostrils. Shut the mouth. We're going to chant three times Ma Kara with a closed mouth. Okay. Next we'll do Anulom Vilom Pranayama. Hands in Vishnu Mudra. Breathe in from left, breathe out from right. Breathe in from right, breathe out from left. Alternate breathing fashion. Left to right, right to left. We will start with the left and we will end when we breathe out from left. Again, hands in Vishnu Mudra. You can chant any mantra, chant Gayatri mantra with coordination of the breathing. But do deep breathe in, deep breathe out.
Okay, conclude when you breathe out from left, or complete the mantra if you are chanting, then turn the lights down. You can bring your coverings right next to you. So while laying down, try to do Matsyasana for few seconds before we go into Yog Nidra. So lay down on the back, and right after the Matsyasana, we will be starting the Yog Nidra. So few seconds is really important to divert all our energy which we gain. We're gonna divert the energy towards the head. So we're gonna bring the palms under the thighs, lift the whole trunk up, toes stretch outward, keeping the legs straight and keeping them together, keeping the trunk up in the air, bring the top of the head back to the floor, continue looking towards back and stay in Matsyasana. Next few seconds while I start the Yog Nidra. And once Yog Nidra starts, just make sure you should not move at all. So I will tell you when to come out of the pose and stay in Shavasana pose. Okay, lay down in Shavasana now. Just come out of the pose, cover yourself, just be comfortable.
शरीर को पूरी तरह से फ्लोर पर सरेंडर कर दिया है। शरीर का पूरा वजन फ्लोर पर ट्रांसफर हो रहा है। और अभी मैं जो जो बॉडी पार्ट्स का नाम बोलूं, वहां अपनी अवेयरनेस लाना है और वो बॉडी पार्ट को रिलैक्स करते जाएंगे। रिलैक्स ऑल योर टूज वन बाय वन। रिलैक्स बोथ योर फीट, सोल, हील्स। Relax your calf muscles, your lower legs, knee joint. Now bring your awareness on your thighs. Relax your thighs. So now both your legs are completely relaxed. Now bring your awareness on your lower abdomen. नाभि से नीचे के सभी muscles relax कर देंगे। और ध्यान लाएंगे नाभि के ऊपर, अपने belly button पर ध्यान लाएंगे। अभी अवेयरनेस लाएंगे पेट पर, पेट के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे। पेट के सभी ऑर्गन्स पर रिलैक्स कर देंगे। अवेयरनेस थोड़ी ऊपर की तरफ शिफ्ट करेंगे और चेस्ट के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे। चेस्ट के सभी ऑर्गन्स भी रिलैक्स कर देंगे, लंग्स, हार्ट। दोनों हाथ रिलैक्स कर देंगे। दोनों हाथ की सभी फिंगर्स, दोनों पाम्स हथेली, दोनों रिस्ट, दोनों लोअर आर्म्स, एल्बोस, अपर आर्म्स, दोनों शोल्डर्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे। और अभी चेस्ट के सेंटर में ध्यान लाएंगे। फील द वाइब्रेशंस इन योर बॉडी। और अभी ध्यान लाएंगे गले के ऊपर और गले के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे। फिर फेस पर ध्यान लाएंगे और फेस के सभी मसल्स रिलैक्स करते जाएंगे। चिन रिलैक्स करेंगे, लिप्स, दोनों चीक्स रिलैक्स कर देंगे, नोज, दोनों ईयर्स, दोनों आईज, आईब्रोज, फोरहेड एंड टॉप ऑफ द हेड। फील द वाइब्रेशंस इन योर बॉडी। Your whole body is relaxed now. Now we will chant 3 Om और Om के vibrations पूरे शरीर में महसूस करेंगे। नाभि से start करते हुए Om बोलेंगे और वाइब्रेशंस पूरे शरीर में फील करेंगे। स्टार्ट, ब्रीथ इन in your body. ओम के वाइब्रेशंस शरीर के अंदर भी है और शरीर के बाहर भी है। मूवमेंट करके ये वाइब्रेशन को डिस्टर्ब नहीं करेंगे। खाली आनंद की अनुभूति करेंगे, परम शांति का अनुभव करेंगे। अपने आप को एकदम हैप्पी हैप्पी महसूस करेंगे। अपने आप को एकदम हेल्दी महसूस करेंगे। ग्रेटिट्यूड की फीलिंग कि भगवान ने मुझे सब कुछ दिया है, अभी जो फीलिंग्स है उसे बनाए रखेंगे। धीरे से पौड़ी के प्रति सजग हो जाएंगे, हेड को साइड टू साइड मूव करेंगे, शरीर को एक स्ट्रेच दे देंगे, दोनों हाथ ऊपर की तरफ खींच लेंगे।
Okay, keep the eyes closed throughout the closing process and prayer until we close the session. Turn the body towards right side and stay on the right for few seconds. Using both the palms, bring the body up back to the sitting posture and get ready for the closing the session. Sit in any cross leg posture, relax the shoulders, spine erect. Three Mahamrityunjay mantra followed by meditation and closing prayer. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam उर्वारुकमेव बंधनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षियमामृतात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमेव बंधनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षियमामृतात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनान् मृत्योर्मुक्षियमामृतात्। Keep the eyes closed, join hands at pranam mudra. Asato ma satgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrutyor ma mrutam gamaya. Om purnamada purnamidam, purnat purnamudachyate, पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाताय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कच्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। Let's rub the palms against each other. Generate heat. Place the warm hands on the face and eyes. Cover the eyes in middle of the palms. In dark, blink the eyes few times. And spread the fingers over the forehead. Slide the hands down over the face. Place the hands on the head, shoulders, hand, and the whole body to spread the energy what we just gained. That's conclude the session. Jai Shri Krishna.